Hey everyone, my name's Natasha and I'm a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. And so this weekend I had a Stampin' Up! Party and we focused on making fall cards. And this was one of the fall cards we made. It's just a fun fall birthday card. So I'm going to walk you through how I made this card. You'll see a list of products below the video of all the products I used to make this card. So if you're interested in anything, you'll be able to find what you're looking for. So the first thing you're going to need is some cardstock. I just got some plain red cardstock. It's a deep red, so it really reminds me of fall. And I used the Stampin' Up! Trimmer to cut it. And so I just cut out just a cute little card. What's great about the trimmer is not only does it cut, but it also perforates the edge here. So it's just nice and easy to fold. And you don't have to mess with crinkling the edges. Things like that. So it's really easy. So that's the first step. Once you have that, you can use a corner punch to just cut the corners. So I just slide this in here and I punch out the corners. It's just nice and easy. I use this seriously all the time. I'll use it for cards, I'll use it for pictures, you know, when I'm doing scrapbooks. It's just really awesome. Definitely recommend you get one of these. So now that I've punched out the corners of my card, I'm going to take some designer series paper. This is from Stampin' Up. I'm not sure if they carry this still. I'll verify that in the comment section below and let you know. But just really cute paper. You can use any kind of paper you want. And just measure it out to make sure it'll fit on the bottom of the card. Once you've done that, you get your corner punch again, and just punch out the bottom corners. You don't really have to worry about the top corners because you're going to cover it up with ribbon, so you won't be able to tell. Once you've done that, get some tape. I use the Stampin' Up! Snail. It's really nice. It'll just roll the tape right on the paper for you. And whenever you run out, you can just buy a refill and refill it. So it's really great. So once you tape it, just line this piece with the bottom of the card. You can really tell by lining up the corners here. And just stick it on. Next, you're going to get your ribbon. This is actually a ribbon I found at Michael's. It was on sale. So I just went ahead and grabbed it. But Stampin' Up!'s got some really cute ribbon as well. I always try to get some when I can. So what you're going to do is you're going to line it up with your card to see how much you need. Don't be afraid to go over the amount. See, I've gone over the edge here because you can always trim it later. So it's no big deal. So I just cut that piece for now. And then I'm going to get the sticky strip, which is Stampin' Up. And I'm just going to measure that across here. Measure it on the line between the green and the red. And cut out however much you need. Okay, once I've done that, I'm just going to peel back this other layer here. It's double-sided tape, so now it'll be sticky. And I'm going to take my ribbon, just place it over the tape, like that. Like I said, you can go back, trim off what you don't need of the ribbon, and voila. So next, we're going to start on our pumpkin. Just get some orange fun paper. This is designer series paper as well, in the same packet as this paper. So again, I'll try to list that if I can find it. If not, just any fun orange paper will work. And you're going to need the oval punch. So Stampin' Up! Has all of these fun punches. They're really handy. Can use it for a lot of things, and they're easy to store, which is really nice. So whenever you want to use it, you just unlock it. You're going to pull out your paper and put it in the punch. Once you have it lined up, just punch out your circle, your oval, I'm sorry. And so you're going to need three of these. I'm just going to punch out three ovals. Okay. Once I've done that, I'm going to take the snail and I'm just going to tape around the edge of two of them. Just tape around this far edge. And then I'm going to stick them on each other. So I'll stick that right there. That right there. So we're starting to make our pumpkin. Then you're going to get another piece of green paper, kind of like what I use at the bottom. I just use it for the stem. So you're going to get that paper and you just cut out the stem. Some people are worried that their stem won't look really good if they're freehanding it and just cutting it out themselves, but it's a pumpkin stem and pumpkin stems all look different in real life, so I wouldn't worry about it too much. And then you just use the sticky strip again. Cut off a little piece. Tape it to the bottom of the stem here. And you can just peel it back. Sometimes it can be a little tricky to grab. Don't worry about it too much. You'll get the hang of it after a while. Then you stick this in the back of the pumpkin. So you have your stem. Okay. So now that we have that, I'm going to get some dimensionals. Stampin' Up! Dimensionals are really great. They just add a lot of dimension to your card. So I'm going to stick these in the back of the pumpkin here. And then you just peel back the other side. Like that. Okay. Then you're going to stick this on your card. The top of the ribbon. Just kind of line it up where you want it and just stick it down. And there's your pumpkin. So the next part we're going to work on is the happy birthday. So you're going to take just a brown piece of cardstock, cut out a little rectangle, and then trim the corners with your corner punch. Okay. And then you're going to stamp. I use the Age Awareness stamp set. It has some really great stamps in here. I've just been able to make some really cute cards with it. I really like it a lot. And so you're going to take this. These are actually the polymer stamps. I think I'm saying that right. And so they're really neat because they stick really well to the blocks that you need to use. Stampin' Up's really cool because we have wooden stamps that we sell, but there are also clear blocks and clear stamps. And so you just peel off your stamps and you just stick them on this clear block. And what I love about it is whenever you're going to stamp, you can see exactly where you're stamping with the clear block. So it's really pretty cool because you never have to just guess, oh, I hope I'm in the right spot. You can see exactly where it's going, which is really neat. So once you put that on, you're going to need ink. I use the Elegant Eggplant ink pad. You just push it back, it rolls over for you, and you're ready to stamp. Get some on the ink. I actually need a harder surface for this, so I'm going to put it over here. And then I'm just going to stamp my happy birthday like that. It's a really cute happy birthday stamp. I'm going to move this out of the way. Oop. And drop it in the process. That's okay. So with a happy birthday stamp, I just cut out around it. If you're really worried about precision, I would recommend using the Stampin' Up! Trimmer because it will cut it perfectly. I'm not really that concerned about it with this card, so I'm just cutting around it with scissors. So I'm going to do it a little closer than that. Just so it'll fit. Just cut it around. Trim it a little more. There you go. Then I'm just going to grab some dimensionals just to give it a little elevation off the card, so it'll look pretty cool. So I just put the birthday down, stick it there, and then put some on my happy birthday, the happy part of the happy birthday. Okay, and I did it crooked on the first card. And then you can take a button just to add a little bit more. I'm just going to use a dimensional to stick the button on. You can use sticky strip too if you'd rather use that instead. And then take some more and stick them on the back of this part of the card. Can't forget to peel those back. And then I'm going to stick it right here on the card. And that's all there is to it. This was a pretty easy, simple card to make. And it's a great little birthday card that you can give to friends. And there it is. So stay tuned for my next videos, and I'll show you some more great fall cards.